Ever wondered how the supplement creatine works in your body and why many fitness enthusiasts incorporate it into their workout routine? Well, let's embark on this fascinating journey together. Creatine is a popular supplement, particularly known for its potential to enhance athletic performance. It's especially beneficial during high-intensity, short-duration activities like weightlifting and sprinting. When used appropriately and within suggested dosage guidelines, creatine is generally considered safe for most people. Most research studies have explored the effects of creatine supplementation over short periods, typically ranging from a few weeks to a few months. There's limited long-term research on the effects of continuous creatine supplementation over many years, but current evidence indicates that short-term use is unlikely to cause significant health risks for healthy individuals. Some studies have even suggested potential benefits beyond athletic performance, such as cognitive enhancement. Now, how about we delve deeper into how creatine actually works in your body? To truly appreciate the benefits of creatine, it's crucial to first understand how it functions in our bodies. Creatine is a naturally occurring substance found in our muscle cells, and it plays a critical role in energy production during high-intensity, short-duration activities. You see, during these kinds of activities, our muscles require a rapid energy source to perform at their peak. That's where creatine comes in. The science behind it is fascinating. Each of our muscle cells stores a compound called ATP, adenosine triphosphate, which is often referred to as the body's energy currency. When you contract your muscles, ATP is broken down into ADP, adenosine diphosphate, and a phosphate molecule. This reaction releases energy, which powers the muscle contraction. However, the supply of ATP in our muscles isn't infinite. It gets depleted during high-intensity activities, and when it runs low, your muscles can't perform at their maximum capacity. This is where the real magic of creatine begins to shine. Creatine, stored in your muscles as creatine phosphate, steps in to help regenerate ATP. It donates its phosphate molecule to ADP, converting it back to ATP. This process replenishes the ATP supply in your muscles, allowing you to maintain high-intensity performance for a bit longer. That's why you'll often hear creatine being associated with increased strength and power output during workouts. It's not that creatine directly makes your muscles stronger or bigger. Instead, it helps your muscles produce more energy, allowing you to work out harder and longer. And ultimately, that leads to muscle growth and improved performance. So, to put it simply, creatine helps your muscles recover their energy supply more quickly during high-intensity, short-duration activities. This quick recovery can translate to a few more reps at the gym or a slightly faster sprint on the track. With this knowledge, you can now understand why creatine is so popular among athletes, especially those involved in activities that require short bursts of energy. So, what can you expect to gain from using creatine supplements in the short term? Well, the first and foremost benefit that comes to mind is enhanced athletic performance. Creatine is widely recognized for its potential to boost performance during high-intensity, short-duration activities such as weightlifting and sprinting. This is because creatine plays a key role in the production of adenosine triphosphate, or ATP, which is the primary source of energy for your muscles during these types of activities. Now imagine this, you're in the middle of a tough workout, your muscles are screaming for a break, but you've still got a few more reps or sprints to go. This is where creatine comes into play, helping your muscles produce more ATP to keep you going, and the result? You might be able to push out those extra reps or sprint a little faster, which can lead to improved performance over time. In addition to its performance-enhancing effects, some research suggests that short-term creatine supplementation might offer cognitive benefits as well. Studies have shown that creatine can help improve memory and intelligence test scores, making it a potential brain booster as well as a muscle builder. Now let's talk safety. Current evidence suggests that using creatine supplements at the recommended dosages, usually around 3 to 5 grams per day, is unlikely to cause significant adverse health effects for healthy individuals. That's a pretty reassuring fact, isn't it? However, it's not all sunshine and rainbows. Individual responses to creatine can vary greatly. Some people might experience side effects such as gastrointestinal discomfort or muscle cramping. It's always wise to listen to your body and adjust your creatine intake accordingly if you experience any discomfort. While these short-term benefits are enticing, it's important to remember that not everyone reacts to creatine in the same way. And, as with any supplement, it's always a good idea to consult with a healthcare professional before starting a new regimen. After all, your health should always come first, whether you're aiming to lift heavier, sprint faster, or just improve your overall well-being. While creatine is generally safe for most people, it's crucial to be aware of potential side effects. While the majority of individuals who use creatine supplements experience no adverse effects, some people may encounter a few minor side effects. One of the most commonly reported issues is gastrointestinal discomfort. This discomfort can present itself in several ways, including bloating, diarrhea, or stomach cramps. These symptoms typically occur when a person takes more creatine than their body can effectively absorb at one time. Another potential side effect to be aware of is muscle cramping. Some creatine users have reported experiencing muscle cramps or pulls, particularly when they are dehydrated. It's important to note, however, that the link between creatine and muscle cramps is not definitively established and requires further research. Now, while these side effects may be minor, they can certainly be bothersome. And it's essential to remember that individual responses to creatine can vary widely. Some people might experience these side effects, while others may not. In addition to these potential side effects, there are also certain individuals who should exercise caution when considering creatine supplementation. For instance, individuals with pre-existing kidney or liver conditions should consult with a healthcare professional before starting on creatine. This is because creatine is processed in the liver and excreted through the kidneys, so any pre-existing conditions in these areas could potentially be exacerbated by creatine use. Similarly, those taking certain medications, such as non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs or diuretics, should also consult a healthcare professional before starting creatine. These drugs can impact kidney function, and combined with creatine use, could potentially increase the risk of kidney damage. In summary, while creatine is generally safe for most people, it's not without potential side effects. However, these tend to be minor, and can often be mitigated by following recommended dosages and staying well hydrated. While these side effects are generally minor, it's always advisable to consult with a healthcare professional before starting any new supplement regimen. Now, what about the long-term use of creatine? Should we be concerned? The question of long-term creatine supplementation is a complex one, largely because there's limited research that has examined the effects of continuous creatine use over many years. Most studies have focused on short-term use, typically ranging from a few weeks to a few months. But what about those who use creatine for years, or even decades? The current body of evidence doesn't point to significant health risks associated with long-term creatine use, at least when used within recommended dosages, which are usually around 3 to 5 grams per day. However, this doesn't necessarily mean that extended creatine supplementation is completely risk-free. The truth is, we simply don't know for sure, because more research is needed to fully understand the potential impacts of long-term creatine use. That's why it's important to approach any supplement, including creatine, with a degree of caution. Just because a supplement is widely used and generally considered safe doesn't mean it's appropriate for everyone, or that it can be used without regard to dosage and usage guidelines. Individual responses to creatine can vary widely. While many people use creatine without experiencing any adverse effects, others may encounter side effects like gastrointestinal discomfort or muscle cramping. It's also important to remember that certain individuals, such as those with specific medical conditions or those taking certain medications, should always consult with a healthcare professional before starting any new supplement regimen, including creatine. So, where does this leave us when it comes to long-term creatine supplementation? In a place of cautious optimism, perhaps. Creatine has demonstrated potential benefits for athletic performance and possibly even cognitive enhancement. However, until more long-term research is conducted, it's wise to use creatine responsibly, adhering to recommended dosages and usage guidelines. When it comes to long-term creatine supplementation, it's always wise to be cautious and consult with a healthcare provider if you have any concerns. After all, the goal is to enhance performance and health, not to compromise them. So, let's quickly recap what we've learned about creatine supplementation. Creatine is a popular supplement used to bolster athletic performance, especially in high-intensity, short-duration activities like weightlifting and sprinting. It operates by aiding your muscles in producing energy during heavy lifting or high-intensity exercise. Short-term use of creatine, typically 3 to 5 grams per day, seems to be generally safe and may even provide additional benefits such as cognitive enhancement. However, individual responses can vary, and some might experience side effects like gastrointestinal discomfort or muscle cramping. When it comes to long-term use, the jury is still out. While there's no strong evidence suggesting serious health risks with continuous use, more research is needed to fully understand the implications of extended creatine supplementation. Whether you're a seasoned athlete or just starting your fitness journey, it's important to make informed decisions about your supplement use. Remember, when in doubt, don't hesitate to seek advice from a healthcare professional.